have introduced and discussed the possibility of new type of Compton camera, electron tracking Compton camera. Now, in early this year, we completed, as indicated here, the balloon flight model using this principle. And already we measure the performance on the ground. Therefore, now we introduce the real data using this method. And so based on this data, we want to discuss what kind of physics in particular for the GRB or AGN measurement. I want to discuss. In particular, also we mentioned about the measurement of the polarization. At first, I would like to briefly introduce the MEV astronomy. Maybe, as you know, in the MEV region, there are quite so little data. Only 30 objects were found, and sensitivity is quite so low compared to even the GB regions. Sensitivity was about so two orders. Also, all sky survey data is presented was only so competent. Therefore, after 2000s, we have no data about in the MEV regions. Also in the sub-MEV region, integral presented only 10 or something, some limited data, in particular above so 500 kb. But as you know, MEV gamma ray region is quite so fruitful region. Traditionally, line gamma ray physics is very famous in this region because maybe this region was explored by the nuclear physicists. Therefore, so many MEV gamma ray astronomers concentrate line gamma ray physics. It's quite important for understanding nuclear synthesis. But also, continuum gamma ray in this region become so quite so now promising because, for example, gamma ray emits the continuum gamma ray dominantly in sub-MEV regions. Also, in this region, it's quite so also important for understanding the particle acceleration because so now in JEV or TEV regions, so what particle is accelerated quite important, electron or proton? But it's quite difficult to identify. Even in the combining as JEV and TEV data. Only recently so Fermi provide this year some so evidence in the so particle acceleration. But it's a supernova Lemland spectrum is below banded in the GB region. Therefore it's not so cosmic origin. Therefore it's still we have no clear data about the cosmic origins. But if we combine the MEV data, for example, it's a, if we can identify the so pi zero peaks, it's a, some good so evidence. Also for the excitation gamma ray line, carbon or oxide is a quite unique evidence for the proton acceleration. It's a maybe best evidence to identify proton acceleration site. Therefore, MEV gamma ray is also quite important in the particle acceleration physics. But as indicated here, only so quite so little data. So, but Comptel opens this field. Comptel is also, it's a quite typical Compton type telescopes. Forward detector catches the so, gamma rays and scattered electrons, and backward detector catches the so scattered gamma rays, and using these informations, we solve the so Compton scattering equation, and we have a direction of incident gamma rays, but not point at the circle, because usual Compton telescope cannot measure the direction of electron. So it's usually we define the two angle resolutions. It's so direction of for Zenith Angles arm and so arm sorry Zenith and Azimuth Angle resolution of SPD. So usually Compton type telescope can measure only arm resolutions. So we have two reasons for the difficulty of gamma ray observations. One is a huge background from the albedo and also satellites irradiated by cosmic ray. Cosmic ray hits the satellite and so atmosphere and generates many, many isotopes, and it generates also wave gamma ray. Therefore, in this region, detector becomes a dominant also background source. It's a quite so difficulty problem. Also, another problem is the obscurity of the image, because now we can get the direction of the incident gamma ray as a circle, not point. Therefore, imaging is a quite difficult thing, because in the overlapping, so circle, circle, circle. So computer, but have a so good so tools, additional tools. It's a so time of flight between so forward and backward detectors. Using this information, computer group separated so background gamma rays or so neutron particles like a this. It's a time of flight spectrum minus. It means so down upgoing particles from the albedo or satellite base. It's quite huge. So even so up and down going signal, it's including signals, but also still 90% the background. Therefore, if no background detector we develop, only so small a few square centimeter I feel time source 10 square centimeter effective area provide us so quite so good sensitivity, like so similar to a Fermi and satellite. So it's a leader of computer groups, Professor Schoenfelder suggested so low background is the most important for the next wave detectors, and concretely he suggested good angular resolution. It means also good energy resolution. Also, redundancy like a TOF is, TOF is important. For example, kinematics using some or the, it's my so proposal to using so energy loss rate using the this particles. Also, measurement of electron direction. It's a quite simple reason because we obtain the so point direction. Also, low material and light weight in the satellite are also quite important to reduce the background. It's also, after computer finishes, there are many groups started the so, development of the computer camera. But in my remember, several groups launched the balloon, but now three groups only reported. One is also, it's a so Columbia group using a so liquid xenon types Compton camera. I omit the so details explain. It's use the quite so large liquid xenon. Therefore, effective rate quite large, 20 square centimeters. But it's a so expected energy range and so it's a expected effective rate. But in the paper, they said maybe effective area is only this small values, and also they expected only so 50 photon, but they could not detect the club signals. Also, maybe for this, maybe so Dr. Zograva showed so day after tomorrow to speak. Therefore now. But it's a quite so important detectors because they can detect the so club signals. It's a quite so great so advance in this field. Their type detector is a use a gallium germanium strip detector. It's a maybe best energy resolution type. So here we introduce a quite different type quantum camera because our key point is that how to increase the redundancy. Therefore, our detector measures all physical parameters in the quantum scattering. It's a direction of electrons and so energy loss rate of this so recoil electrons. This liquid xenon detector also ideally this detector could measure the so electron tracking, but it's a quite heavy material. Therefore, it's not so good for measure the low energy electron direction. Therefore, we use a gas, and so we constructed the time projection chamber. Time projection chamber is a quite so now common technique in so high energy experiment. Usually, it's the technology is used to the collider experiment to measure the so 3D dimension of charged particles. Then by measuring the direction of electrons, we can limit the direction of gamma rays, not circle, other arcs. It's a quite difficult to consider the point because even in the gas, such a 10 kV or 20 kV electron scatters quite difficult. Therefore, only so we have a Leica so arcs, obtain arcs, but it's quite so important thing to, as I mentioned later. Also, by measuring the energy loss rate, the directions also we can carry out the so particle identification. It's quite important for rejection of neutron. In the atmosphere, there are many neutrons generated, and also it's attacks at detector. Also using, also we have another additional angles between the so scattered gamma rays and recoil electron. Using this angle, we try to so kinematical check for event by event. It's a examples of so real events. Only so we use so 1/10 of event to source clearly separate. Also, these are real images for also we applied this detector to a medical image. We obtain a so very clear image. Also, actually, we use some molecular imaging. It's only mass, it's a so rivers and tumors. Another point in this detector, we use a gas, therefore, it's quite so simple detector compared to so semiconductor detectors. We use such a micro pattern detectors developed by ourselves. Key point, now we omit the details. But it's also quite standard structure of time projection chamber, but different is I want to use for the so satellite or balloon. Therefore, we cannot so load the so huge electronics. Usually TPC connects the electronics to all pixels. In such a case, electronics increase the more than so millions numbers. It's quite huge for the so satellite use. Therefore, we developed some special methods connecting strips. Therefore, number of electronics are quite small. It's a real image, but so sampling rate is quite small, only 400 micron pitch. Therefore, we obtain like a so cloud chamber image like this, but it's a first step images. Therefore, there are many scared. It's a quite scared images. And so TPC surrounded by the pixel scintillator. We use NASA GSO. This have a quite so strong so stopping power. Already we obtained the angular resolution similar to the semiconductor type Compton camera, about 4 degrees, about so 400. 600 kV. Already we carried out the first test using only so 10 centimeter cube electron tracking compton camera from the Japan site. It's also key point is it's also simulated circumstance of so high latitude. Key point is it's a gamma ray background, also it's a neutron background. Well, key point is there are many neutron background heat detector. It's a but for our detector, it's quite easy to remove because it's a energy loss in the gas chamber and it's a track length. Therefore, this relation indicates the energy loss rate, electron energy loss expected rate, and it's a muon rate. There are many cosmic ray heat detectors and electron here. Separation is not so good. But so neutron usually scatters a proton. Proton energy loss rate is in this level. They are perfectly neutron can be removed quite easily. Therefore, as indicated, it's a trigger rate. And so by cutting the neutrons, about one order background reduced. And after applying some kinematic fitting, it's a remained Compton event in the 400. It's a quite similar to expected simulation. Therefore, as indicated here, our Compton camera.
Those are data you're showing taken at the float altitude. At the float altitude. Data you have shown at 35 kilometers.
Yes, yes.
All this.
Also, this number of events is quite similar expected number of the cosmic diffuse gamma rays and so atmospheric gamma ray events. Therefore, we fit the diffuse cosmic rays and the data is quite consistent with the previous data. Here now we summarize about the noise direction of electron tracking camera. At first, our concept is quite so traditional because we use a light material in the gas, it's a gas. Also, we use a quite heavy material as a backward detector. In that case, it's a quite so ideal structure while rejecting a backward gamma ray. This is quite simple. Gamma ray hits its so heavy material, usually absorbed in a so hot absorption. Therefore, as indicated here, if we use so one radiation length scintillators, about one-tenth gamma ray can penetrate, hit both. If we use the two radiation lengths, it's a quite negligible effect. This expected data is quite consistent with the previous balloon experiment. Another reason is how to reduce the background in the ETCC is that using a so SPD. Because it's a so event circles in a so computer for the gamma ray burst. Therefore, no background. But usually, circle event is distributed, it's quite large area. It means if it's some persistent sources, also background also affects the so pointed source region. Therefore, it's quite difficulty of the Compton telescope. But if we use SPD, quite so this region is restricted. It's another reason to have to reduce the background in the so electron tracking Compton camera. But the problem is quite low efficiency because in the so SMILE 1 means the so first experiment effectively only 1 or 2 millimeter square. It's quite small. Efficiency is 10 minus less than 4. It's two reasons. One reason is a quite small volume. Another reason is that at that time, as indicated here, tracking efficiency is quite low if we need so three-dimensional electrons. Therefore, now we improve the, this part. Now we can reconstruct. Therefore, this efficiency improved about 10 times. Also, we increase the volume about 30 centimeters, 30 cubics. But it's not so large, only This scale, the weight is about 80 kilograms, including so crystals. So it's a tracking, it's a previous tracking, it's a recent, now so present tracking. Also now we measure the, so each point's pulse width. There also we can identify the black peaks, therefore scattering point and end point. Also hit number of tracking increased about 10 times. It's a previous method and a new method. Also total weight is only so 300 kilograms. It's lighter than previous one because we developed, changed all electrons in a small type. Now we carried out a performance test. These are detectors and source. We use in Japan, we cannot use a strong source. Now it's only so 0.7 mega becquerel cesium source. And here we define so two parameters, phi geometrical, phi kinematical. Phi geometrical is a scattering angle of the calculated, and it's a obtained so scattering angle. Therefore, real Compton event concentrate this line. It's a real data. Fine, as indicated here, now this detector clearly separates the Compton event at the background. So, by such improvement, this is also energy loss rate. It's a previous data, it's a new data. Now we can clearly separate the electron. It's a stopping in TPC. In that electron, we can use. It's also escaped, it's a simulation. Therefore, it's also escaped muons, and so it's a, I'm sorry, escaped electron. It's a Compton event, but it's a quite so misleading. It's a become a background. Therefore, we can remove such a background Compton event. This is a muon event is concentrated. There's the track length is 30 centimeters. It's also about the height of the detector. Also, it's a correlation by cutting this part, clearly background is removed. Also, this is also images obtained as so, a point source. Key point is by applying such a this DDX cut, most background can removed here. It's quite important because emission from the celestial object almost is a continuum gamma ray. Therefore, we cannot apply energy cut. Therefore, until now, we have no cut for such an object. But now we can apply this cut about so more than half backgrounds we can omit. Finally, we apply the energy cut, and so it's a quite so strong contrast. Also, another point is that this is only so scatter plot because we can measure the both directions. Therefore, we can plot the other point. Therefore, very easy to subtract the background. Usually for a Compton event, it's quite difficult to remove the background spectrum because maybe so Dr. Zograva explained that we need the so maximum likelihood expectation maximization method to remove background. But for our case, it's quite easy to. Also, gas is quite simple. Therefore, angular deposition also we obtained so quite so good angular deposition. It's a so limitation expected from the energy resolution detectors. It's a DSO. Also, if we use a so quite expensive scintillator. We can reach about 2 degrees in so 600 kV. It's quite similar, also limit in so semiconductor resolution. Also, another point is we obtained the SPD resolution less than 100 degrees for the more than 10 kV electron. Therefore, now we can use SPD information for the almost all event. Also, Berkeley group. It's not so astrophysical part measured as SPD resolution using a 10 micron pixel CCD tuned measured as SPD angles recently. They reported only 200 degrees less than 100 kV. Therefore, it's a maybe best resolutions. Even this resolution is twice of the multiple scattering effect. Therefore, after I talk about the pressurized gas, if we pressurize the three times, only so maybe resolution expected resolution is quite similar because these resolutions still so dominant the systematics. But this resolution is quite so powerful now as indicated. It's a imaging so improvement by SPD. Key point, this plot, red indication is based using so SPD resolution of the 100 kb's. But this is a real image. It's a three same energy sources and it's a so strong source and it's a 1/5 of these two sources. Key point is the contrast. This background is a quite low level and it's a strong source. This is a, if we don't use the SPD formation, it's obtained images. It's a very so separation is not so clear. Also another point is that there are many so artifact image appears like this. Also contrast to background level and so point source is only two or level. Therefore, four times better contrast we obtain. Also, this detector provides us quite large. This elongated image is due to we reconstruct as a plane. If we reconstruct the hemisphere, it's changed to such a circle. Also, that's efficiencies. Now, such an image now still we obtained use only so bottom scintillators. But efficiencies are measured using a side scintillator including. In that case, we achieved about one square centimeter effective area. If it's a requirement for the observation of the club about five sigma about three hours observation. If pressure the key point is perfectly we can simulate this result. It's quite simple because now electron efficiency, the construction efficiency is 100%. Therefore, another part is quite simple because the scintillator absorption or scintillator geometric part is quite easy to simulate. Therefore, simulation accuracy now becomes quite so accurate. By increasing the gas pressure, for example, increasing the three times xenon argon gas effective area increase about 4 or 5 times. But best gas is a CFO gas, this gas, because it's a light material, but it's a molecular. Therefore, there are many electrons, about 40 electrons. It's quite similar to xenon. But xenon is a heavy gas. Therefore, self-absorption occurs in the low energy part. If we, this gas is very common gas in a drift chamber used in a high energy physics. Also, this three times atmosphere is also not so difficult. Already we checked as a quite so weak source. This signal to noise ratio is only so twice in the expected club signals based on SMILE1 background result. at that time, with the one fourth of detectors, there were useful detectors. Maybe about so 4 hours, we get the about so 10 sigma level. Also, it's also become a quite good polarization meters, because usually Compton telescope is a good so polarimeter. But key point, in particular, our detector is a quite simple structure. Only gas box and surrounding detector. There are no structure inside. There it's a quite so ideal polarimeters. It's a now we carry out only simulations, but yeah, indicated here modulation factor expected more than 0.5. 0.6 is maybe one of the best value in polarimeter. Key point is less than 100 kb, there are many polarimeter used as so plastic scintillator. There, it's quite difficult to measure the energies, but Compton type polarimeter can measure the energies quite so precisely. So based now we originally this year we planned to so launch this detector from Japan to observe the club. But now JAXA have a problem about the balloon groups, because so new JAXA base is quite near the so airline course. Therefore, now JAXA balloon can launch only 1 hour. It's quite difficult for the observations. Therefore, now I negotiate so many groups in the world. And now, then, so now just we started the collaboration with the Goddard. And maybe next year, if now we propose JAXA to get some money to launch in the next year's USA, in that case, next year we possible. Now we are proposing. But so what our team now preparing the cost in so 2015, therefore at least we can launch 2015. Also, now we consider the so next step as a, so by pressurizing, only pressurized gas effective area increased about 10. Also, now scintillator, we use a quite so thin scintillator, it's a cost problem. Increase the 2 radiation lengths, also covers all bottom part, 20 square centimeters is easily possible. Also, we simulate for such an example, 4 centimeter cube, 40 centimeter cube ETCC. And so we use the 4 modules, it's sensitivity, reach that 1 millicurve. This weight is about so near the 1 ton. They are not so light. But it's a similar level in another proposal. So from now on, I comment about so expected physics. In a so short day, short time flight, target is a club. It's quite important to certificate the performance. Also, it's also our detector can measure the polarization of clubs. Recently, Integral reported a quite large polarization, both the clubs and the signals. In a polarization is a 0.4 or 0.6 or. But so from now on, we have no another satellite covering in this field. There are maybe so it's a unique chance to reconfirm this data. Key point is for the Compton type telescope, polarization measurement is actually not so easy, because there are many background comes. Sensitivity is quite depends on the so how much is a background. Therefore, such a persistent source, maybe so our ETC is quite good to measure so polarization. Now, expected it's a limit of if polarization larger than 30%, we can measure only so one day flight. Therefore, both larger than 30%. There we have a possibility to reconfirm these data. Next, if after SMILE 2, we achieve the so expected data, now we consider that so polar circle or Antarctic or Northern Pole. In that case, we can observe more than 2 weeks. Main target is, for example, the measurement of the precise measurement of the maybe cosmic gamma ray background spectrum. It's a result of the computer. Computer observed 9 years, 8 years, but 9 years, but error wise quite large. It's a reason is quite simple because such a gamma ray comes all directions. Therefore, it's quite difficult to estimate the background. Therefore, it's a quite systematically quite large. But ETCC is a reduced dramatically background. Therefore, it's a quite good target for ETCC measure this spectrum. Also, this spectrum now many theorists interested in this region because this shapes of spectrum is very so now concentrated the evolution of AZN. There's extant CFAT or flat spectrum radio quasars. Therefore, we measured also anisotropy in MEV gamma rays. But so there we simulate the collaboration of the Dr. Inoue. Also, now we expect about 5 sigma separation, we can measure which AZN type contribute dominantly this field. Also, another main target is the gamma ray part. Key point is our detector is it's a principle of the coded mask type. Therefore, many coded type camera needs so much photons to measure so some patterns. But Compton camera reconstructs a gamma rays. Therefore, only it's a field of views. Data concentrated in this field, in particular, electron computing Compton type camera restricted very small area, 10 degree level. Therefore, dramatically, background was reduced. In particular, such a method is quite so useful for the long, quite long duration gamma ray burst expected in the population 3. Recently, SWIFT reported the quite long gamma ray burst about so duration time is 10 to 5 or 4. But it's quite strong. Also, it's another type of the population 3. Population 3 type is expected that the fluorescence is a small, but it's a so quite long duration, more than so 10 to 4 seconds. In such a case, quite difficult to detect another type of detectors. Also, gamma ray polarization is quite important. It's also a common target for the common type of conventional type of Compton camera. It's a reported polarization for the gamma ray burst. It's a quite large values, more than almost more than 30%. So, for the quite big gamma ray burst, even in a balloon experiment, sensitivity is indicated here. 10% polarization is okay, about 3 sigma level. For the common type, about 30% polarization is okay. Therefore, it's an expected number. It's quite big, so gamma ray burst. Even in a so balloon type detectors, we expect near about so more than so thousands event. In that case, we can measure the polarization. It's an expected rate here one or two in a, one month flight. It's such a big gamma ray burst. About so several in a medium type. Therefore, if we fly to the several times, we can catch such a big gamma ray burst. Also, maybe this type of talk, so Dr. Zograva presented, because key point is that it already measures also, line distribution in the galactic. Key point is that our detector has a good separation of the pointed source. Therefore, if we have a some sort of sharp, clumpy field, it's a good target for the observations. It's a quite strong source, as indicated here. Only so one flight, long duration flight, there are many events observed in these fields. Their statistics are quite enough. Key point is how to remove the background and to reconstruct the fine structures. Also, there are many, so about 10 sources possible in the galactic plane. Was ozone area. So it's a summary. Key point is now ETCF obtains both strong background detection and also high contrast imaging by measuring the direction of electrons. Key point is ETCF has a nearly one order better sensitivity than usual Compton type with, if effectively are similar. Then now we have a plan to at first step, SMILE2 having a so 10, 1 or 4 square centimeter level launched in so US to measure the club or signal polarizations. And the next step, we improve the sensitivity to about more than 10 square centimeters. And so we want to carry out the long duration balloon. And so there are many physics even so balloon experiment. That's all. Thank you for your attention.